By now you might expect that we've found out all we're ever going to know about ancient history. That isn't the case, though. Technology is helping us carry out more detailed investigations than ever before, and old sites are continuing to give up new secrets. As well as ancient history, we're still coming across modern phenomena that cannot be explained. This video features some astonishing discoveries about both the ancient and new world that have only recently come to light. Penguins come in all shapes and sizes, from the appropriately named little penguin to the more impressive emperor penguin, but even an emperor penguin is barely over 3 feet tall. That's positively tiny compared to its ancient ancestors. The Kumimanu baisiae was recently identified following a German study of fossils located in New Zealand, which was once the prehistoric penguin's homeland. Based on the fossils, the birds would have been 6.5 feet tall. That's about the height of the famously tall football player Peter Crouch. It's taken 60 million years of evolution for them to shrink back down to the size we know them as today. That's probably for the best. A 6.5 foot high muscular giant penguin could overpower a human being with ease. A remote location in China has recently been discovered to contain the fossils of over 100 different prehistoric creatures. That would be exciting on its own, but the fossils are the oldest ever recorded, at 518 million years old. Not only that, but just over half of all the animal fossils found at the site, which has been named the Qingjiang Biota, are completely unknown to us. This period of Earth history is known as the Cambria Era, and was the time when many of today's common animals first appeared on our planet. It's hoped that detailed study of what's been found at Qingjiang may answer many questions that scientists still have about the origins of life on our planet, as well as evolutionary changes that have occurred over time. On the banks of the River Don, in the Ilovlinsky district of Volgograd, is a mysterious mound which has fascinated both tourists and scientists for years. Gold digger Peter Avdiv attempted to excavate it in the late 1800s, convinced he'd find gold buried within it, but was puzzled when all he could retrieve from the dig were charcoal carts. More recently, a research team from Volgograd University, led by Professor Anatoly Skripkin, have had more luck in determining its origin and purpose. This was once a temple, used by Indo-Iranian fire worshippers, built in honor of their fire god Agni. A 16-foot-high furnace was constructed here, with white limestone walls as insulation that kept the fires burning for days, spreading smoke that would have been visible for miles around the site. Carbon dating tests have determined the temple to be around 3,000 years old. What is this object that washed up on a beach in Carolina, USA, in October 2018? A lot of people were convinced it was part of an alien spacecraft. Those suspicions intensified when the local government quickly came to take the object away, without explaining to anybody what it was. Visually, it appears to be part rock and part steel, but eyewitnesses say the mysterious object was soft to the touch. A more innocent explanation could be that it's a piece of a pipe float, or part of a large buoy. It may also be discarded military equipment, which would also explain why the authorities were so keen to get it under wraps, before anyone could investigate too closely. Could it now be inside Area 51? Or is it just another bit of washed-up technological junk? We've never seen anything like it before. Archaeologists studying historic burial sites have discovered many different types of rituals related to interring the dead, which vary from civilization to civilization. Nowadays, people are either buried in graves or cremated, but thousands of years ago, there were many more options, including the dramatic Viking method of being pushed out to sea on a burning boat. Now there's another one to add to the list: post-mortem tattoo work. Polish experts excavated a burial mound on the banks of the Dniester and found a 4,500-year-old female body, upon the bones of which black paint had been administered, Evidence suggests that the paint had been applied several times, suggesting that the burial site had been revisited on multiple occasions and dug up to allow for fresh painting to take place. No civilization was ever recorded in this area, which suggests this woman was buried far from home and afforded unusual respect. She's been nicknamed the Princess of Yampolsky, but could she have been a witch instead? Humans have gazed up at the stars in wonder ever since our time on this planet began, but no civilization ever seemed as fascinated with the heavens as the ancient Egyptians. That's best illustrated by the ceiling of the tomb of Senenmut, an Egyptian architect and government official from around 1500 years BC. Upon that ceiling is what's come to be known as the Egyptian celestial diagram, which contained a full map of stars and constellations seen exactly as they appeared thousands of years ago. What baffled scientists for years was the positioning of Orion to the west of Sirius, rather than the east. After extended study, we now know that the Egyptians worked out north and south according to the position of the sun, rather than the Earth's magnetic poles, of which they'd have had no knowledge. That solves a part of the mystery, but we still don't know how the Egyptians mapped the stars so accurately without telescopes or technology, nor why they constructed the pyramids to be in perfect alignment with Orion's belt. What did they know that we don't? Tattoos are increasingly popular in recent times, with most of our favorite sports people and movie stars having at least a little ink on their skin. They're not a new idea, though. In fact, we now know people have been getting tattoos for at least 2,700 years. That's because of the discovery of a tattoo kit in Tonga. The kit itself was discovered in 1963, but it's only recent forensic examinations which have revealed its purpose and composition. Although evidence of crude tattoos has been found on mummies up to 3,000 years old, this is the oldest purpose-built piece of kit ever discovered, and is surprisingly similar in construction to some of the tattoo guns still used today. It even has a special place for the mortar and pestle. The bulk of the tools are made from four bones, two of which belonged to seabirds, and the other two, a little scarily, belonged to humans. We like to think of ourselves as more in touch with our friends and family than previous generations. And that's because of the internet and social networks. Social media lets us relay messages to friends across wide geographic areas and build stronger networks between ourselves and other people. Sorry everyone, but this kind of mass communication isn't new. It's been going on since before the founding fathers arrived in America. Recent studies of pottery collected from Tennessee and Georgia and dating from 800 AD to 1600 AD shows that stamps placed on wet clay as pottery was being made signified friendships, news, political developments, and even power struggles from one village to the next. As two people or two towns grew closer together, more and more aspects of their pottery design work would become intertwined. A person in one village receiving a pot from a neighbor would be able to look at it and instantly understand the meaning of the stamps, like getting a newspaper. It might sound strange, but a person from 1000 AD would think your most recent Facebook status update was a little weird too. It's often said of the British people that they enjoy the occasional beer. From the Romans to the Anglo-Saxons, every civilization which has ever settled on the British Isles has loved alcohol. So it's no surprise that beer drinking is so deeply ingrained in their culture. A recent accidental discovery has now revealed that beer has been brewed there even longer than anyone imagined. Road workers digging up land in Cambridgeshire in preparation to lay down a new road unearthed Iron Age relics from 400 BC, including rudimentary brewing residues. What initially appeared to be lumps of charcoal later turned out to be full of bubbles and traces of grain, which together were a sure sign of fermentation processes. It's thought that fermentation was first performed to purify water so it could be drunk safely, but the enjoyable side effects were quickly discovered, and before long, ancient brewers were making beer purely for pleasure. Beer drinking has been going on for a long time, but chewing gum has been around for even longer. We don't think you'd have enjoyed the sort of gum people were chewing 9,000 years ago, though. It certainly wouldn't have tasted minty fresh. Scandinavian hunter-gatherers used to chew pieces of birch bark to make it soft and pliable. When it was sticky enough, they would then use it as a bonding agent so they could make tools and weapons. The existence of the gum, which has mostly been recovered from in and around Husaby Klev in Sweden, has been known about for some time. What's changed recently is that scientists can now extract DNA profiles from traces of saliva left in the gum, which has revealed that it wasn't just the men of the Mesolithic tribes who made weapons. The saliva of women and children is also present. Maybe the family who chewed gum together stayed together. Cheese, like wine, is sometimes thought to get better with age. Don't let that tempt you into sampling the world's oldest cheese, though. It would make you extremely ill. This cheese was found in the tomb of Ptolemais, the former mayor of the ancient Egyptian city of Memphis. Scientific testing has revealed it to be 3,200 years old. You couldn't eat it even if you wanted to. The passing of time has hardened it into a solid mass. But within that mass are traces of Brucella melitensis, a bacteria which causes brucellosis. That's a disease that still exists today, and most commonly infects people who drink unpasteurized milk. Why Thomas was buried with cheese is unknown. Perhaps during his rule over the city, he improved its farming performance? We are still sending probes and other technology to Mars in the hope of proving that life does or did exist there. But at least one prominent scientist believes we've proven that already. Sri Lankan-born British astrobiologist Chandra Wickramasinghe has been studying meteors and asteroids that have come to Earth from Mars for years, and now believes he's found clear evidence of a microscopic egg in one such rock, known as the Tissint meteorite. The egg-shaped object is rich in both oxygen and carbon, suggesting that it came from a living organism, which the scientist believes was most likely algae. His fellow researchers from Cardiff University agree with his assessment, and therefore feel that the tiny egg is the clearest evidence yet of life on the red planet. The rock itself is millions of years old. If there were algae on Mars millions of years ago, what could it have evolved into now? More importantly, where is all that life hiding? Subscribe to the channel and turn on notifications, and you will be the first to know when a new video comes out. Thank you for watching, and see you soon.